Yo, what's up, guys? I've been pulling first place with mage build for last, five out of 7 games. Five out of 8 games. I lost one mage setup. Went full feathered another one. Went full archer another. But I've been kind of pushing mage, and I just wanted to show you how I'm proficient with it and how I go about it. So enjoy. There, I see the desperate doctor. I could have grabbed both of them, and went the god mage way. Desperate doctor is strong early too, and I would have got him 2 stars, so he would have been just a good unit. But I'm still more concerned with the front line. God, he isn't 2 star. I got nothing for the front line, really. So that's what I'm concerned about. Then I get some goblins here. I get a venom. So that's cool. I would have been able to 3 star that doctor, but let's save that for another game. I would end up wanting to go Glacier Knight if I end up getting a 2 star doctor out the gate. So. The last mage video I put on YouTube was just super simple, easy game. So this will demonstrate how to compete with mages against a better lobby. The last lobby wasn't quite as good. We got some king twos, king ones, and a queen in here, so get that wind ranger. I don't know. At this point, I don't know what I'm gonna go for. I'm just picking up everything that looks good. Checking out what they're doing. Boom, then we got the Flaming. It's a great unit early round with or without the mage bonus. And I sold those thinking I was gonna get to 5 gold, and you can see I'm downloading on my phone, and it's real laggy game. The whole game's super laggy. So like there's times when I want to roll, there's times when I want to switch my pieces, and I just can't because I know it's going to take me extra long. You'll see a couple times I do a switch and I'm just not able to complete it because of the lag. And even with his 2 stars, we're able to beat him. Now we got Mahjong by round seven. Gonna commit to it. A lot of people don't like they think the units are weak, and they are weak units, but they're also strong units, if that makes any sense. They die quickly. They can't take a lot of damage, but they also can dish a lot of damage. So high risk, high reward kind of thing here. We're starting to take some good damage. Get hit for like 15 here. 12 here. Losing on both screens. He loses his win streak. That's cool. Boom, got a thunder. Anytime I get a prime unit like that, I roll again. Feel like the shop's trying to bless me. So, boom, another blessing. Another blessing. Roll again. Shouldn't have rolled here, but I do get what I need. So, there we go. Now our econ's suffering. We can sell him. I was putting Tortula Elder in there because I didn't think I had my human buff up. I did though, so and we're just getting wrecked. We're gonna take a lot here. No, we beat this guy. But look, Pepega on his screen's beating us. This guy's almost beating us, so that's just letting us know I really should have pushed nine there. I really should have rolled. But I was more focused on my economy and getting to 9 and 10 for end game than I was securing a good streak right now. And another reason I don't push nine hastily, because and we take a lot of damage there. We're above 40. We only have two more rounds to the creep rounds, and that will allow us to get to nine and still have 50 economy. I switch in full god now. Everybody else is kind of wrecking us. But not to worry, our econ is up. Everybody else's economy is down. Cammy Axe, but he's not even leveled up. I'm going to be two levels ahead of him with the same economy, so. Ten to lose against everybody because you can see they spent their gold and we're being greedy. And instead of leveling up, after, I'm gonna just do it before and try and mitigate some damage, get that dragon back in there. Yeah. Now, decide to roll a little bit. Trying to get these two stars. But I always do this like an idiot. I'm rolling during a creep round when I could have saved my economy. I do that so often, and it just is irritating when you look up and you see you're in a creep round. I do decide to push 10 just because I have a unit to put in. And now I'm worried about two starring. Got a Thunder and my helicopter. And at this point, we are all winning on our own screens. I should have worried about picking up them Tortula Elder. But that's who I was going for. I was going for two star God of Thunder. So we hit him pretty good. Papega. What did we hit him for? Six, so like 12. And I'm dumb for rolling at three with nothing to sell to buy anything. I'll check out their placement. I got that Venom. Yeah. In hopes that he will be targeted by Taboo Witcher. And that was just a terrible ult on my part. But we still managed to. Still managed to win this. Papega could have hit us hard there. When that Tortula doesn't hit. A few units, it just makes me really angry. And see, just lucky there. But if I would have been spending my money on Tortula, I would have never got that. And you can see I'm lagging. My downloads are taking a toll right now on my game, so I'm not gonna be able to get everything in position. But it's kind of good because his Dark Spirit doesn't get off and then we just destroy him. But he does win on his screen. Yeah, he does win on his screen. And we're just doing great. We got everything we need, two starred everything. We could have had some three stars in there, but in this, it's all about being able to adjust. If I would have went for three stars, I wouldn't have got a lot of these other essential units to two stars when I did. And then we probably wouldn't be in top third place win streaking right now. You know, so you need to know when you need to sacrifice certain units, when you need to not pick up units that you want to pick up. Have a end goal. And have fun. We knocked him out. And now we're just going against this last guy. Little early GG. He ends up winning quite a few rounds on his screen, but it's just a matter of time. I switch over to get was gonna switch over, but my phone's lagging to get better alts off. Thunder Spirit, Tortula. Boom. Boom. And see, but he is beating us on his screen. So he's hanging in there. I do switch sides. Hoping to get some better alts off. But he also adjusts. And destroys us on his screen. So we were close to losing, but when I go gods, or I mean when I go mage, I notice that. Like I'll watch when I play against them and see this was stupid. I should have just saved the egg, but I upgrade it. This is where I was telling you earlier where I was gonna get my 3-star Tortula ensuring victory, but I tweak my phone tweaks and I don't pick up my Tortula Elder. Where is it at? Right, this next roll, huh? No, there it is. Boom, and I click the button. No. This one. Yeah, see, and I missed it. I double clicked it like an idiot. Yeah, see. Ugh, so sick. Doesn't matter. Still winning on this screen, but we are win streaking. Boom, Strange Egg. That would have secured our 3-star Elder and the game, but what are you gonna do? Probably could have had two-star God of Thunders out there too. That would have been cool. And Tsunami Stalker, Dark Spirit, Siren. Those are some other units to put in a mage build like this that I like to put in. Good game. And you can see, let's see, we go against, I think, one queen and a couple other king players. Yeah, one king, king two, king two, king one.